sound of the Vulcan and those four Olympus engines. All sorts of theories as to why that half happens. I don't think anybody really knows. But it does, and it is the trademark of the Vulcan. Big Olympus Rolls-Royce engines, 16,400 pounds of static thrust in each of them. So, flying the Vulcan for us today, in the left-hand seat, captain is Kev Rumens. Ramsey, and the third man of the crew, the air electronics officer, sitting at the back, Barry Mason.
I think some have probably spiked on Martin's Weetabix this morning.
Towards us today. Bear in mind, this is a 60-year-old aeroplane. The design, the model of aeroplane, 60 years old. And with her contemporaries, the Valiant and the Victor, designed to carry the British nuclear deterrent. Role in her. We're not allowed to do that these days, but as you can see, she can still turn a pretty maneuver. All doors open. You see that enormous bomb bay underneath. That is the bomb bay that carried 21 1,000-pound bombs all the way to the Falkland Islands in the longest bombing raid in history, flown by the captain was then flight lieutenant Martin Withers, who was awarded the DFC for that, and it dropped 21 1,000-pound bombs on the runway at Fort Stanley with the help of 11 tankers to get them there. It was an extraordinary occasion because Vulcan had stopped being a nuclear bomber by then. She was right at the end of her service operational time, and she was then a low-level tactical bomber. Closing as she comes by for the second time. This aeroplane was actually the first V2 version of the Vulcan into our air service from Tupolev Command in 1960. This particular aeroplane is a mere 52 years old, just a stripling. She served on the operational conversion unit. And then on 101 squadron and 44 and 50, all of which were at what she carries the colours. Bomber Alley of the Royal Air Force, and the Panthers Head number one group on the nose, representing all of the Vulcan squadrons in the 1970s. Also, a newer addition, she has the Spirit of Great Britain painted on her nose, encapsulating all that she stands for, the great British never say die bulldog spirit. Effort ever since by what has become the Vulcan to the Sky Trust that she has been enabled to be with us now. It's cost more than £10 million and it's still costing £2 million a year to keep her going. And we've had help from the Heritage Lottery Fund, we've had help from a lot of the British aerospace industry, also the Civil Aviation Authority, Marshall, the Engineering Authority. But most of the money has come from you, from the great British people. You've given your money in amounts between £1 and tens of thousands of pounds to enable this magnificent aeroplane.
fowl again, not quite as much as on the second front, a wonderful howl. And as you get up to the top there, Ted Rumors has put the wheels down, and I think he'll come by in front of us again with the wheels down, and then he'll come in. So, as I was saying, it's costing £2 million a year to run this extraordinary aeroplane. She is unique. There will never be another aircraft flying like her. And it's amazing to think that there's a piece of paper still in existence dating from 1946, when the great Roy Chadwick, who designed the Lancaster and seen it fly only 5 years before, sketched out the first Vulcan. And what's even more extraordinary is if you elongate this picture of the first Vulcan, you see that it becomes recognisably Concorde. So she is a direct antecedent of Concorde. And of course Concorde had Olympus engines too, although rather more developed than these. So if you want to see this aircraft again, join the Vulcan to the Sky Club, vulcantothesky.org is the website. But please also go down to the Vulcan. It's off to the right hand end in the Cold War display area. You'll see it there, not very far from where the aeroplane is parked. So please do go down there, all sorts of good things to do down there. And you can buy all sorts of merchandise. You can try the Vulcan simulator, which is always good fun. That hasn't happened is that she hasn't got a name sponsor, a title sponsor, and that is what we've been hoping she would have all along, but she never managed to get it despite absolutely gargantuan effort all over the world to get a title sponsor for her. So that's why we are still dependent on your money to keep this aeroplane going. Incidentally, if you go down to the Vulcan village at the right hand end, you will see very near to where the aeroplane is, an actual, of course, a dummy blue steel missile, part of the Cold War exhibition, and that was the nuclear weapon that later Vulcan did eventually carry. If you look in the bomb bay of the aircraft, in one of those guided tours around the aircraft, you'll be able to see the special cutout shape that allows the blue steel missile to be carried. It's an absolutely enormous thing. But of course, it doesn't weigh as much as a 21,000-pound bomb, which weighs around about 10 tons. So that's all available to see. Please do go down and check at the bar company. Also, if you want to give some money directly, you can do it from your mobile. You text VULC 12 for the year, and one more figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 10, and that is the number of pounds you want to give. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 10. So if you want to give £3, you text VULC 123 to the number 770 70 70, and all that money goes to Vulcan Sky Club, and you will also be charged with that. I think we'll see Ted Rumens holding the nose up as she goes by, so that great slab of a wing slows the aeroplane down. You see the air brake sticking out top of the bottom of the wing there. He's keeping, actually getting the nose a little higher. And finally he lets it drop. Two nose wheels come down, all 18 wheels back down on the runway here at the Royal International Aerospace.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
I can't tell you.